Good morning students. Today we will start a new chapter, winds, storms and cyclones. We have already discussed the basics of this chapter in our live classes. Now let's get started. First of all, we will try to understand the properties of the air, that air exerts pressure. We know that air exerts pressure. And why we are not able to feel that pressure? Because of the fluid pressure or the blood pressure which is there inside our body. This we have already discussed, that from inside our body is exerting the blood pressure and from outside the air is also exerting the air pressure, and both are cancelled out. So we don't have a net pressure, total pressure is zero because we don't feel it. We don't feel it because of the blood pressure which is exerted from inside the body by the blood. So that is the reason that we are not able to feel that much enormous amount of pressure. Although it is there, but we are not able to feel it. Now this activity also we have already discussed, just to show that air exerts pressure. In this activity what we did, we took the Pepsi can or Coca-Cola can where we filled it 3/4 with water and then we boiled the water. After boiling, the water turned into steam and the air which was present in the upper portion, it escaped out. Because the steam which was generated, it pushed the air outside and air escaped out. The moment air escaped out, after some time, after 5 minutes of boiling, we closed the lid so that air will not come inside again, because we know the property of the air, second property, that air occupies space. The moment it gets the space, it will try to occupy. But right now air is escaped out and the space is occupied by the steam. After closing the lid, we will pour a cold water over it. Now initially it was evaporation which was there, or boiling. Water was converted into steam. Water was converted into steam, or the water vapor. After pouring cold water, again the steam got converted into water. So on heating, on boiling, water got converted into its another state, that is steam, and on cooling it came back into water. So the steam, it was condensed and it came down and it was a part of the water later on. And here we know that this portion which was having steam, now it is empty, or the vacuum means the empty space. No air, nothing is there. Now we know air exert pressure, and we will feel that this can is smashed now, or it is crushed because of the air pressure. Why the air pressure which was present earlier was not able to crush this can? The reason is earlier there was air pressure from inside, or later on there was steam pressure was also there, but once the steam also condensed down, so later on there was no steam, no air from inside, there was vacuum or the empty space which was present inside. So air from outside was able to exert a pressure, and because of that the can was crushed. Now this activity we have already discussed, so without much delay we will start the next activity, that is activity 8.2. In this we will study about, we will prove this phenomena, scientific phenomena, that is high speed winds are accompanied by reduced air pressure. Whenever there are high speed winds, later on there is a state of reduced air pressure. The air pressure reduces, the pressure of the air reduces after the high speed winds. So why it happens and how it happens, if you want to prove it with the help of activity, we can prove. So now we will study this activity which is given, that is activity 8.2. Crumple a small piece of paper into a ball of size smaller than the mouth of an empty bottle. Here you have to crumble some pieces of paper and you have to keep the pieces of paper nearby the entry point of the bottle. Hold the empty bottle on its side and place the paper ball just inside its mouth. Now try to blow on the ball to force it into the bottle. Now the boy is blowing air and trying to force that piece of paper so that it can get inside. Try the activity with the bottles of different sizes. Challenge your friend if they can force. But to your surprise, you will find that this ball will not get inside. It will try to come outside. The paper ball in by blowing into the bottle. Paheli and Buju are thinking about the following question. Why is it difficult to force the paper ball into the bottle? Now Paheli is amazed. The why it is happening that it is very difficult to blow or difficult to force this paper ball inside. Rather it is coming outside. Because we know this phenomena, and this phenomena clearly states that high speed winds, because this boy is exerting pressure, air pressure, and creating high speed winds, and whenever there are high speed winds, they are always accompanied by reduced air pressure. Air pressure is reduced here because the boy is blowing air, so air pressure is lesser here. So from inside there will be more air pressure and it will try to force the piece of paper to come outside. Instead of going inside, the paper is coming outside because inside the bottle there is enormous air pressure, and at the entry point of the bottle there is reduced air pressure. Why the air pressure is reduced here? Because we know the high speed winds are always accompanied by the reduced air pressure. Thank you very much. Revise well.